Friends, today we have with us one of Goa's known cricketer who has done a lot of cricket, who has played a lot of cricket for Goa from the junior levels and then went on to play for India under 19s and then again played for Goa in Ranji Trophy, Duleep Trophy and a lot of cricket all over. We have Saurabh Bandekar with us. Welcome, Saurabh. Jeevan welcomes you. It's a casual chat show with you and we are just trying to take some time and get to your memories, try to recollect what you have done for Goa. You started playing cricket at very young age, I believe, at the age of 12. What was your time?
Yeah, actually I started playing cricket with the leather ball at the age of 11.
Okay.
That's when I joined the summer coaching camp in Pedem,
okay.
Which was coached by Nitin Venekar and Chandrakant Chede and Anil Agulkar.
Okay.
So yeah, that's when I started cricket.
So you were academy sort of thing, people wanted to boost on you and you were a fine of that lot who were going in the camp. Who amongst you other boys were there at that age? Anybody you remember?
Yeah, at that age I think Rahul Keni has been one cricketer who started cricket
with you. Yeah,
okay. He's been with me throughout.
Okay.
That's the only guy I can remember, and I think Rohit Asnodkar.
Rohit Asnodkar. Yeah. So you three guys and then you guys made it big.
Yeah.
You started playing at the age of 11. What was that thing that pulled you towards the cricket basically?
When I was kid around 10-11, my uncle Pushpashir Bandekar, he had played a lot of club cricket in his days. So he had his own kit at home and stuff, and we were a joint family staying together. So I used to wear his kit and like stand in front of
him. So you got attracted towards the kit. It's a very general tendency of every person,
yeah,
every kid. Yeah. Especially you like to wear those gloves, yeah, and then you try to feel the pads and a lot of.
Yeah.
So that was the way. So Pushpashir Bandekar was the one of your person instigating you to get into cricket.
Yeah. So that's how I started.
What age you played? Which school you were in? Saraswat School.
I was in St. Brito's. I did my schooling in St. Brito's. Unfortunately, they didn't have a cricket team
at
that time. But I still played cricket.
Okay.
And they recognized it, but they didn't have a cricket team. They started playing cricket only after I passed out.
Yeah. Okay. And you never played for Saraswat School. No relation with Saraswat.
No, I did my high secondary college in Saraswat.
That is the time you click.
We played for Saraswat. We had a brilliant team.
Yeah, you were the champions.
Yeah, we were champions 2 years, once in college, once in high secondary also. So. Yeah.
And then first time you came into the Goa under 14 team, I believe.
Yeah.
If I remember. Yeah.
Yeah, we played under 14 for Goa, which was in Bangalore.
Okay.
Rahul Keni again. Yeah. Me and him.
You were leading the side or no? You were not.
No, I wasn't leading the side. Wasn't Akshikar, if I remember.
Okay. Okay.
The side. So yeah, me and Rahul Keni, we made debut for Goa in the under 14 tournament.
Okay. That was your start for Goa, and then after that you started only leading the Goan junior sides, I believe. Goa under 15, under 17, under 19, whatever came your way, and Saurabh Bandekar was leading.
Yeah, I always
It is a surprise, basically, a bowler leading the side. Were you bowling at that? I mean, what was it?
No, the thing is that I started out as a batsman. I was always a batsman.
Oh.
Since under 14, I started playing for Goa as a batsman. And I used to bowl, but I was a part-time bowler.
Okay.
I used to bowl the ginger medium
places. Okay.
That's what I did. So I started captaining since under 15.
As a batsman, of course, and you were getting runs, I believe. So
yeah, I was getting runs. I was one of the leading run scorers at that time. So that's how I became the captain. But I started bowling since the under 17s. But the captaincy remained.
How it started? You got selected, played for Goa under 15, then you went on to play captain of under 15, then under 17 you were the captain of Goa again. You're batting. And how it started? Like, what was it? You were in some.
Yeah.
I remember somebody telling me you were in some camp or something, and somebody.
Yeah, the thing is that under 15, I was the captain, so I could bowl a lot. Like I bowled whenever I felt like I bowled, and I thought I did a good job at that time. When it came to cutting down the runs. So under 15, I batted, I scored runs as well as I bowled my gentle medium paces, and I got a few wickets, which got me into the National Cricket Academy in Bangalore.
Okay, great.
And Venkatesh Prasad was our bowling coach.
Oh, Venkatesh Prasad.
Yeah. He was our bowling coach at the academy. So he saw me bowling and he liked what he saw. He was impressed by whatever I showed him. So he actually told me and like advised me to start bowling medium pace and taking it seriously, more seriously. So that's where I actually started my bowling.
You listen to his advice and you are what you are today. And exceptionally, so I can say Venkatesh Prasad is your creator as a bowler.
As a pacer, you can say. But
batting is your natural talent.
Batting is my natural talent.
Yeah.
But a lot of my a lot of credit for my bowling I would like to give to Nitin Venekar, because he's been my coach throughout since I was 12 at that camp till today. Even today when I have some problem or anything, advice to be taken, I go to him and I have a chat with him. So he's been my coach.
Yeah, he has, of course, everybody whom I have talked, and of course he was my captain at one time when I played cricket. The crop of Mafsa boys, as we say, Harshad Gadekar, Swapnil Hasnarkar, Saurabh Bandekar, Rahul Keni, Rahul Keni, and all these boys of you who have done so well, they always talk about Nitin sir, and they go on to Nitin sir for that particular. And he has done a lot because you guys are playing now for Goa, and then we'll have some people, other people taking over, other boys taking over.
Yeah.
So we need to get the same crop of guys happening, but I hope so it's happening around.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah.
Whenever I go to the ground, I see these young, talented guys.
Yeah.
A lot of good leg spinners, especially. So, and Nitin sir is really taking interest, like, he's one man who's always committed and dedicated.
Committed. That's absolutely right. Coming back to your cricket, you started then bowling, and you were a good batsman. It, normally, psychologically, it goes into cricketer's mind. At that age, tender age of 17, you are a batsman, then you're a bowler. You never got into a confusion, what I should be doing, like?
No, I never got into a confusion really, because I was young and I just wanted to play, be it anything, batting, bowling, anything given, any job given to me, I would do it, and I enjoyed my cricket at that time. It is now that we decide, we have to make decisions, and now we're mature and stuff, and we actually think about it, all that. So, but that time it wasn't about
confusion.
So much thinking and everything.
Whatever, you will go on the ground and do everything.
Just play and perform for the team. Yeah.
After you started doing all so well, you from the NCAA, you played for Goa under 19. You were leading Goa under 19.
Yeah, I led Goa under 17 also.
Okay.
That's when I did another NCAA National Cricket Academy camp for under 17s. So then again, I got some guidance in bowling and stuff.
Okay.
So I continued.
And then you were, by the time you reached 19, you were quite a formidable all-rounder for Goa.
Yeah.
So you were almost 60-40 or 50-50. 50-50, I cannot say, but at least 55-60. You were decided to bowl, you had a role to do with the bowl and bat, and plus lead the side.
Yeah.
So you're carrying a lot of weight on your shoulders.
That was a lot of pressure.
How well did Goa do under your captainship under under 19?
Under 19.
Are you comfortable on the performance?
I was very comfortable, I was very happy, and I had a great team with me. And I think under 19, we did an excellent job when we were playing under 19. I think we, as far as I know, we were the best under 19 team Goa
at that time.
Goa, yeah.
Okay,
Goa,
great.
And because we,
yeah, and you're at the top league.
Elite panel, yeah. That's when we played and we got promoted to the elite
group
for the first time ever.
Okay.
So we played and we lost there, but it was a good achievement that we reached the elite group. But after that year also, we won a few matches under my captaincy, and I had a great team, like Amit Yadav was doing really well now, he was with me, Rahul Keni was with me. So yeah, I had an excellent team, I enjoyed.
So your dream of having the under 19 team, a good team, and then you walked on to the India under 19 scene. That's how we know Saurabh Bandekar. All of a sudden, people all around know Saurabh Bandekar came in the India under 19 team. You played the World Cup straight away. How was it? How did you play for India in India under 19?
No, actually, there was a one-day tournament for under 19 in which I did really well from there. And plus the 3 days which we had, I got picked into the South Zone under 19 team.
Okay.
So we had All India Interzone Tournament in, I think, Bangalore, Calcutta,
yeah.
If I'm not mistaken. Yeah, that's where I played my game at the historic Eden Gardens. And I bowled really well for South Zone and got a few wickets, and I was bowling at good pace.
What was your pace
good
like?
Pace. I never measured my pace, but I knew that I was bowling at a decent pace at that time. And yeah, that's when Venkatesh Prasad was going to be the coach of India U19 team. That's when he saw me and he recognized my talent and he picked me from there to play the
Yeah, I had also met you in NCS, so he knew what was happening and so on. He really worked on himself.
Yeah, he knew my everything.
So he backed you up long way. And you got into the India U19
side. I got into the India U19 side.
Which was that? World Cup or what?
For the Afro-Asian tournament.
Afro-Asian, okay.
Which happened in Vishakhapatnam, and we won the tournament.
Okay.
We had Pakistan, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka and South Africa
and Zimbabwe.
So we won the tournament. I did really well as a pacer. I was the highest wicket taker amongst the pacers.
Wow, great.
Yeah, I got 10 wickets in 6 games. So
then you got picked up for the World Cup.
With that performance, I obviously had to be in the World Cup side. We had a few selection games in Pune with the Proverbs. Again, there I did well.
Who was your crop of boys from the India U19 crop who are playing good now in the cricket?
Cheteshwar Pujara, I played with Ravindra Jadeja, Virat Kohli came with me, Ishan Sharma played with me, Rohit Sharma.
Ishan Sharma also is in your...
Ishan Sharma, I did a tour with him to go to Pakistan.
Okay.
And Piyush Chawla.
Okay.
And then a lot of guys, you see.
Who are playing for India, right?
Yeah.
So you are in the reckoning phases all the time, in the India zone also.
Yeah.
You played India, then I think you are also... all this while I was thinking I am the only Goan cricketer who has played in Pakistan, but it's so that Saurabh Bandekar also made a tour to Pakistan with under-19 India side.
After the World Cup, there was another tour going to England, but I wasn't included, unfortunately. But after that, I got picked again to go to Pakistan. We played in Lahore at the Gaddafi Stadium.
Wow.
I got picked for the one-day deal. So yeah, I played at the Gaddafi
Stadium. What did you feel at that particular time, you being an Indian, being a Goan, and you must be feeling that, like how I was feeling that I was the first guy or I was the only guy, you must be also feeling that one Goan reaching to Pakistan and playing. Of course, you can reach to England, you can reach to Australia, but going to Pakistan and playing, it must be a terrific feeling for you.
Yeah, that's the...
Lot of lassis around.
That's one time I can't remember me being so excited. Ever. Like that's one time I was so excited to go to Pakistan.
Weren't you scared also?
Not really. I was under 19.
What was your parents saying? They were ready to send you across?
Yeah, they were because it
got a risky time at that particular time. I remember a lot of bomb blasts taking place in the Sri Lankan team being there and a lot of things.
That time it was risky, but we had an excellent security force which were there with us. Once we got outside our room, you could see security outside our room.
Even in the hotel.
In the hotel, everywhere. We went to the ground with like.
So you really enjoyed it. It was a different kind of environment.
Yeah, totally different kind of environment. I had a lot of fun. I had a blast.
Well, when I played in Pakistan, I didn't play for any national team. I had no security. I was just an Indian playing for a club from UAE team, UAE Sharjah. And we were just enjoying it. But there was no security for me. Because they did not know whether I was an Indian first.
Yeah, that's true.
When did you make your Ranji Trophy debut for?
Actually, after Afro-Asian, when I picked those wickets.
At the same time?
The same time Ranji Trophy was happening. So, as soon as the Afro-Asian got over, I was called and I was made to join the Ranji Trophy team. Yeah.
What's the story about your action in Bradley? What is all this? They call you, what is your pet name they give you?
Pinga,
Bandu, a lot of pet names.
No, that's actually Bradley's pet name, Binga.
Yeah.
Actually, Binga, Bradley, my action was nothing like Bradley. It's just that our coach Dodda Ganesh
started keeping it.
Yeah.
But I do find your action not totally like Bradley. At least your the jump and the release time. I don't know how you run the different way, but the release is quite similar to Bradley.
Maybe, but I.
Did you any time pick it up? Because of course, Ganesh Prasad guided you. That was very early. I don't think Bradley was much in the show at that point.
No, he was the fastest bowler in that.
And so you already had him in your mind. What he was?
No, surprisingly, I never had Bradley.
But you watched his action. Because the release is the same.
I watched him a lot. But intentionally, I never tried to imitate or copy him or anything.
When you started bowling, you were a person. I remember when I played one friendly game with you, you were quite a bowler who used to bowl those outswings and. But did you focus on the pace Or did you focus? That was when you were just 13, I believe.
We were 14. We were going to an under-15.
Yeah, I played for a Gymkhana team.
That's the time I was a batsman, so I used to bowl gentle medium.
Yeah, you said the ginger medium
pacers. Yeah, that time. But after.
But as you grew up from that zone from 15 to 19, 17 to 19, in fact, from 17 to 19, those 2 years, then you decided that I'm going to be a very fast bowler, or you were still happy with. You wanted a swing and the fast.
I wanted swing, obviously. It's always good to have movement when you're bowling. But as I said, I took pace bowling seriously only after when Venkatesh Prasad advised me to. After that, when you're a pace bowler, you obviously need pace. So I used to give it my all, I used to put in my effort. But Nitin sir always said one thing in the nets. Whenever I bowled, he said, just try and bowl quick, don't worry about anything else.
Wow, that was great.
That's one line he must have repeated at least 100 times with me.
Wow.
Every time I came into bowl, don't worry about anything, just bowl quick.
Bowl quick.
Yeah,
don't worry about the length, don't worry about just come and pump it.
Yeah, just give you 100%, just bowl quick.
Because you had it in you, you had the lean, the strength, the whatever you were doing, and you had the attitude in your mind.
Yeah.
How tall were you then? I don't think so, you were very tall at that point.
No, I wasn't very tall, and even now, I don't think I am that tall.
But you have your limbs which and your workouts and whatever you do, you get your...
Maybe that time I had my natural strength, because I started doing working hard on my fitness seriously only after my 20s.
Okay.
But that time, Nitin sir, you should do...
You had a lot of your back behind your pulling, I believe, at that point.
Yeah.
And Nitin sir must have guided you a lot, because of being a good medium pacer himself.
Yeah.
Coming to your under-19s, I went back to Ranji Trophy again. I'm coming to your under-19s. Pro-Asians, then you went to Pakistan, or in between you went to the World Cup. How was your India World Cup situation? Where was it? And what happened? How was your performance?
We were in Colombo.
Oh, Sri Lanka.
Yeah, Sri Lanka. And everyone knows we reached the finals, but we lost to Pakistan in a really low-scoring game. We got them for 103 and we could manage only 60 odd. So it was a low scoring game, unfortunately for us. We lost the game. But I played 3 games in the league phase.
That was in your panel or was there? No, that was the next year.
Panel.
Yeah.
Yeah, Panel played that World Cup.
Okay.
But he played the next World Cup.
Yeah, as a full-fledged, fully. He was in the side. Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
Who was there from which teams? Can you...
He will be surprised if I tell you that Pollard was in our World Cup.
Sunil
Narayan was in our World Cup. Even we didn't realize that time that they were playing in the World Cup.
Okay.
So all these guys, Sunil Narayan, Pollard...
That left-arm spinner was there. So Ben...
Suleiman Ben was in there.
A senior, 1 year before.
So then Owen Morgan was there. Then this one, Keith Sweater
was there.
He played. From the Pakistan team, we had that Nasir Jamshed. Bangladesh, we had Rahim and this one, Shakib Al Hasan and Tamim Iqbal. These three. And we had David Warner, Aaron Finch.
There's a lot of good cricketers in that particular era or that particular year of when you played under 19. And who went on? Pakistan beat you in the finals.
Pakistan beat us in the finals.
When you were totally a relaxed side, I believe.
Yeah, after the first inning, we got them for 103 and we came, the players came to the dressing room, obviously, because I wasn't playing the game. We were all relaxed. We had it in our mind that we had lifted the World Cup already. But Venkatesh Prasad still warned us that the game's not over yet. We need to score those 103 runs. But I don't know what happened, and wickets just kept falling. We had players like
Venkatesh Prasad was the coach?
Yeah, he was the coach in the World Cup. We had players like Pujara, Rohit Sharma, Jadeja, Piyush Chawla. We had all these guys. And we couldn't
get those.
Manage.
From there on, you became very famous as a cricketer, because playing Ranji Trophy, of course, it's a big title, but playing for India under 19, playing in Colombo, playing in Pakistan, I think you're beating me on that, playing countries where you have played. I have played in 10 countries. I don't know, you must have played more than that.
10? No, I don't think so.
Yeah, have you played cricket in England?
Yeah, last year.
You went and played contact cricket. How was your feel about it?
Good experience. I think I improved my batting there because the condition was slow and wet and...
The ball stops and comes, spongy type of,
So I think I improved my batting.
Why didn't you go this year? You got on the contract or you let the...
No, actually this year I had a problem with my foot, my ankle.
Yeah, okay.
I had this extra bone in my Achilles tendon, near my Achilles tendon, which kept troubling me last season. It kept paining on and off, on and off. So we took a scan and the doctor advised me to get it cut off, get it operated.
It is done now?
Yeah, it's done now. I got it operated last month.
And you need to take a lot of rest?
Yeah, it's 1 month is gone, but doctor's really happy with my progress. He says I'm going to take not more than 3 weeks now.
Guys, Saurabh Bandekar was a hit all the time. Had a little bit of a nasty season last year. Playing for Goa, got dropped in and out, and a lot of runs being hit off his in the one day. A lot of things used to happen on the newspapers, but these are the things which happen for a cricketer. He had a little bit of injury which he couldn't even express himself, and then he comes out with. I hope Saurabh Bandekar, who's given so much for Goan cricket and who has done so good for himself, stands out for the next season and comes out great and shows his mettle and keeps the critics quiet. And I pray to him to recover fast, because that's very important, because he played with a nagging injury and he was just trying to run in and bowl at that whatever pace. At the same time, he did well with the bat. I believe in the GPL also he did a lot of good work with the bat.
Yeah, and
you still got back into your batting likings, and you do always well for Goa in 2020s. I believe you open the innings sometimes before you, and in one day you go a little higher.
Yeah, one
so
day.
You're very attacking batsman and doing all this. So you always tilted from bowling and a little bit of batting. Whenever you have an injury, you just go to batting. And then, what are your plans for the next season? I think you want to come full fit and get the critics quiet and show yourself what your mettle is.
See, that's one positive thing that happened last year during my whole season. I wasn't bowling well at all. That's the time I got some time for my batting, and I put in my hard work and I scored a bit in whatever games I played in Ranji Trophy and even GPL. I scored a few runs, so yeah, I did well in my batting. But as far as next year is concerned, yeah, that's my plan, to get really fit and
I hope you get really fit and take a little rest and show your mettle as 100% fit, Saurabh Bandekar, rather than you keep playing with an injury and then because you know, being a fast bowler, I'm sure you hit the foot so hard, you hit your foot so hard that you, no matter how much confident you are, that you are determined that you are going to do well, but still you are always in the back of
the
mind.
That last moment when you are hitting your foot down, it's always
in the back of the mind. It's going to give you a lot of shocks in your head.
I can't give.
Great work. Still you've been playing and you did, but it's at the current levels you have to really take rest. I would advise.
At the rate cricket is progressing now, it's really hard work out there. It takes out
at a very competitive level and a very healthy competition. Every fast bowler is guiding each other and taking care of each other, and there's very healthy competition of praying good for other person. I've come across these things. It's very nicely happening in Goan cricket. Coming back to your under-19s, you played under-19 against Pakistan and you World Cup, you lost, and then you came back home, and of course you were like a big hero, I'm sure, because you are the first Goan to play in the World Cup, I believe. Nobody has played in a World Cup game for under-19, so you have a lot of firsts. I'll not give you the first to play in Pakistan, I still have it, but you are one of the guys who played in Pakistan, one of the two odd players or three odd players who must have played. I don't know who somebody else has played it. Recently, you and Swapnil have been covered as some international days. So we are not aware what's happening in the circuit, but there are people taking care of the records, what's happening.
Yeah, you know, like they say that you just have to give your 100% on the field and do well for the team, and the records will take care of it.
Yeah, it's, of course, you have played a lot of cricket. Coming to the Ranji Trophy, when was the year you made a debut? Simultaneously, once you played Afro Asian, you came and played, it was around 2005, I believe, you made a debut.
2005-06, that season.
Which was the team and who was your first prize wicket of yours?
We played against Saurashtra. That's the time we were playing Afro Asian. And after Afro Asian got over, I was called for Goa and Cheteshwar Pujara was called for Saurashtra. So that was our debut, both of us. We debuted in the same first class game, playing against each other. We were teammates before that, but after that we played against
each other. Great.
So I think Jogiani was my first wicket.
From Saurashtra.
Yeah, from Saurashtra. Yeah, he was an opening batsman.
Okay. Coming back to your Ranji Trophy, you have around 130 wickets.
Yeah.
How many runs have you got?
That's difficult to tell, but I can tell you that my average is around in the 20s, which I have to improve.
Yeah, because you have, how many Goan bowlers have got 100 plus wickets? I don't think so. Second, there is Avinash Aware.
I think Shadab Jagadi is
the leading wicket taker.
Leading wicket taker.
Then it's you.
After that, it's me.
And then Avinash Aware.
Avinash at 102.
102. And I think Robin is reached 97.
Robin is in 97.
Because he just covered him the other day and he's waiting to get his 3 wickets. All medium paces, I don't know whom I'm backing up. Someday Saurav Bandekar, someday Robin. But all this group of boys, they really have an essence in them. And if the Goa Cricket Association and the Goan team really takes care of them and along with them get some youngsters in, lingers them around together, which they have been doing very nice. Goa had a nice season last year. It must be said that Saurav is that part of a team because he likes to be in the best of the teams. He was a part of Duleep Trophy as well, right?
Yeah, last season I was part of the South Zone team. Yeah.
Okay, and you played the Duleep Trophy. You have played a Duleep Trophy game also for Goa.
I have
two
played,
seasons.
Not last season, but two
previously,
seasons before that. I have played a game for South Zone.
Okay.
And I got a wicket, and then unfortunately, as my luck has always been, I got a side strain after that game. So I couldn't play the full match, and after that I think I lost 1 month on the side stage.
So you walked off again off the ground. There is a match which we were seeing, I think the Challengers, Salve Challengers Cup,
yeah,
when you were playing for India Blues.
Yeah,
and then I think you were, there have been a lot of ups and downs for Saurav, where he has been a hero and everybody likes him and then the expectations go that high. And then he does little bit here and there and then everybody starts talking about him. I think that was also one game which you surely like to open up that episode to me. What happened exactly? You bowled two overs or something like that?
I bowled one over first and then I injured myself while fielding.
Okay.
I strained my ligament as it was told by the doctor. I strained my ligament while fielding. After that, I came back and bowled another over, but I wasn't at my 100%.
I obviously
got hit. Rohit Sharma and Parthiv Patel were batting. So I obviously got hit and I didn't bowl.
Who was your captain that time? Virendra?
My captain was Virendra Sehwag. He's the coolest
guy. I watched that game.
Guy I've seen.
And he gave you the third over as well.
No, he's like, "Are, you can do it, you can do it." I kept telling him that, no, I have a problem here. I can't hold the ball properly. I can't even hold the ball properly. He said, I bowled that second over, I got hit, and I finally told him that, "Viru bhai, ab aur nahi ho raha hai, andar ja raha hu main." So I went inside, the physio told me, "Oh, that's okay, he taped my hand, it's okay, go ahead." Came again, came back, again I got to bowl. I bowled three balls, two out of the three balls went for fours, I think. Again, I wasn't able to hold the ball. So I again told him, "That's it, I can't bowl anymore."
And
so
you bowled out.
I had to take
so that was your, with the India Blue team, whatever you performed at that particular time. You played Ranji Trophy, you got 130 wickets till date, and then you were dropped out from the side, I believe, last year.
Last season.
Yeah, and then you look forward for a lot of cricket to come in the future for you. Coming back to your personal life, you said your uncle was the person who got your parents, your dad, mom, anybody?
My parents, they've supported me unconventionally, whichever. Stage in my life in cricket, everything, they've always supported me, no problem at all when it comes to cricket. Yeah, they've always told me to play cricket and not worry about anything else.
And did your uncle look back to you, does he look into your, your performances, especially you said,
yeah,
the person whom you felt, whom you used to follow on the ground?
Yeah, he follows my performance,
yeah,
because he's really fond of me. He has a daughter, he doesn't have a son, so like I was like his son when we stayed together,
yeah.
I still am. But he always followed my performance. Every time he meets me, he tells me, not exactly about cricket, but otherwise.
Guiding your personal life,
yeah,
how you
exactly
move on.
So yeah, he's one guy who's always advised me, always supported me throughout.
Coming back to your cricket, you played from the personal to cricket again, I mean to say. You have done so well for Goa, you've done so well playing for Duleep Trophy, you played for India under 19s, you played Salve Cup, the Triangular Challenges Cup. You have not got a call for IPL as such.
I did, in the second year of IPL, I was in the squad in the second.
So you got in the IPL side also?
Yeah, when IPL went to South Africa.
Okay.
That's the year I was taken there, and I think we started really badly. We had lost 5 out of 5.
Which team were you?
I was with Bangalore Challengers.
Bangalore. Okay.
Yeah, we lost 5 out of 5, and I was in the. I think I was in the probable, like the.
To play the next game.
Yeah, not in the team, the 15, but the rest.
22. In the
22. Yeah. So, but unfortunately, during one of our practice sessions,
again you had it.
I broke my thumb.
So it was led by Kevin Peterson at that time. Oh,
yeah, that time Kevin Peterson was leading the side.
Yeah.
The team had gone to play a game, which was an away game, and the rest of us, we were at Pretoria, we were training. Mm-hmm.
So you've been to South Africa as well.
Yeah, I've been to South Africa as well. So yeah, we were training for that, and unfortunately, during practice, I broke my thumb. So I had to be taken to the hospital, and I had a surgery at that time, and I had to come back, sadly. Otherwise, I was expecting to play one of the next games, because we were doing badly. So there were changes about to happen. So yeah, unfortunately for me,
again, you missed out.
Yeah.
But you were the part of the team the next season as well.
Yeah, next season again, I had a good season at Ranji Trophy. So again, they asked me, again they signed, renewed the contract with me. So yeah, I was in the team, but I never got a chance. That season, we did really well that season, I think. I think we played the finals, I think.
Do you still talk to Venky when you are not doing well in a Ranji Trophy? Are you eligible? Do you call him up or you talk to him?
No, not on that term. Like, I don't call him up and stuff, but whenever I meet him. Bump into him, since he is into cricket also, I bump into him a lot of times. Whenever I do that, I make sure I talk to him and talk to him about my bowling.
Coming to your performances in Ranji Trophy, you have some extraordinary wickets. Can you tell me some of your prize wickets? Like, who have got the best batsman around?
Recently, the one...
Or international, because a lot of...
One wickets. Which comes to my mind quickly is Amol Mazumdar.
Oh, great.
Actually, I had a tiff with him also while bowling. There were a few words exchanged.
Which that was against Assam?
Against Andhra Pradesh. Okay. He played as a pro for Andhra. I think it was last season, like the season before last. Yeah, I had a tiff with him, few words exchanged, and then I got his wicket. So that was a good wicket for me. And another...
Amol Mazumdar, the highest run getter for Ranji Trophy and the most Ranji Trophy game player. One of the best batsmen India must have ever seen, but did not play much cricket for India.
Yeah.
My teammate basically for the Bombay under 19 days.
Another good wicket I've gotten is Akash Chopra.
Oh, great.
Yeah, Akash Chopra, and he is one of the leading scorers in Ranji
Trophy as well. Both great for India.
Yeah, plus Rishikesh Tanedkar, I think he's an amazing batsman.
Amazing batsman.
Yeah, for me, he's the best team, and Wasim Jafar are the best domestic players. Like, he makes it look so easy.
You have got Wasim Jafar also?
No, I didn't get Wasim Jafar, but Rishikesh Tanedkar I got, because he played for Rajasthan. I got Akash Chopra and Rishikesh Tanedkar in the same
also
game.
Also for Rajasthan.
Yeah, same game. So that's one. And
that is the season when Rajasthan went on to win the trophy.
Yeah. So we played against them. And another team in particular, there's one team, Bengal, which I've always, like, I've played 2 games with them, and I have 13 wickets.
Oh, great.
In 2 games. I've got 6 wicket all in the Ranji Trophy when I played against them, and all these guys, Saha, Manoj Tiwari.
I know that. I was part of the team. Yeah.
Lakshminarayan Shukla, all these guys played in that game, and Ganguly was playing that game as well.
Ganguly made a comeback specially to play against the Goals.
Yeah, so I got 6 wickets against them. That was one game, and another game in we played in Moinuddin against them.
Do you remember me telling you during the game when you were playing a Bengal game, and I remember you had got some 4 wickets, and the Bengal team was tottering at something for 58 odd or 48 odd for 4 wickets down, and I was walking to you and telling you that Bandhu, you have to keep bowling the full day. You said to me, Pishal Agna Tukara.
Are you serious? Well, I don't remember that.
And if you had literally bowled that full day, at least another 2 sessions, I'm sure there would have been a different result. Of course, it was a draw, but you would have a better result.
They went on to score a lot of runs in the later half.
Partnerships from Vidarbha Savali with another batsman, I believe.
Yeah, so that's one team. And another time we played against them was Moinuddin. We played against them, and again I got a fifer in
Hyderabad,
and I got the same batsman out again, Deep Das Gupta and Ridhiman Saha and Manoj Tiwari, all these guys, and we went on to beat them in that Moinuddin game. So yeah, that's one team which I've always enjoyed.
So you've won the Bengalis?
Yeah.
Only cricketers, I believe.
Looks like.
Coming back, he's shy when I say that. He's not even looking at my face. Bandhu, about your personal life, you're eligible bachelor from Goa. Looking, when you plan to get married?
I know that question is coming my way. No plans right now. Right now, I just want to give my all to cricket, and that's.
You still want to give a lot to cricket.
Lot to cricket, and I want to enjoy, live my life to the fullest. I want to enjoy my life, and I. Right now, I'm not
prepared for marriage.
Nothing at all. Not before I'm 30. Definitely.
Oh, great. So you planned it that at 30 is a zone when I start looking for.
That's when I start thinking about it.
Wickets off the pitch. Yeah, basically.
Yeah.
Okay, that's good. Coming to your family life, we explored that your parents are backing you up all the time. Any other person in the cricketing zones or your coaches as you grew up, you would like to mention?
Yeah, I would like to mention. As I mentioned, Nitin Venkatkar, Venkatesh Prasad, Anil Arulkar has always been a good wisher. And then Todda Ganesh, he was with us for 2 years. I learned a lot from him about bowling and about
attitude
and fast bowling attitude. I think that's when I learned a lot from Todda Ganesh. And now Newman Joyce, Sri Lankan Test cricketer. Last season we were with him, so I've learned.
A different kind of a person.
Yeah, different kind of person.
But you get to learn a lot.
From Todda Ganesh,
exactly.
They are totally different persons. Nuvan's also is pretty calm, and Todda Ganesh is
very aggressive.
Yeah, very, very aggressive. So, yeah, get to learn a lot.
I know the Todda factor, I don't know about the Nuvan factor, because I know the Todda factor.
Get to learn a lot by just looking at them. Yeah, so these have been a few guys. Another guy I would like to mention is my uncle from Mumbai. He's been one guy who's always supported me, and he's always, and I call him whenever I have a problem with anything in life, cricket, anything.
Right, right, right.
Always call him, and that's where I get my advice from.
So that's nice. You have played a lot of cricket. You have acquired and achieved a lot for a Goan cricketer, basically. You have played for India in 19s. You have traveled all around the world, almost 6 to 7 countries already on the tip of the tongue. You have done a lot for the cricket, achieved as the performance wise, you have taken a lot of wickets. Any other targets set up for yourself? I think you're the one odd bowler, all-rounding figures. I asked you was that about your runs, which you told me. Because being an all-rounder, having 130 wickets and having 1,000 runs plus, surely it's an achievement, it's another milestone in your records, I believe. So I just wanted to know whether you have completed your 1,000 runs.
Yeah, I have completed my 1,000.
So you are the one of the odd person. I think Shadab also has not done that.
I'm not sure.
You're the one only all-rounder, because we do check at one particular time. When you take even like Ian Botham, Imran Khan, Kapil Dev, which went on to, we used to have those comparative studies.
Yeah.
When we used to have, they have done 100 wickets and 1,000 runs. For an all-rounder, at bowling all-rounder, that's a good enough record and exceptional record to be broken with. I think you're one in the three.